Hey guys, welcome back. Here we are finally to talk about how to use your stomach tube, how to prepare for that, how to use it, and some of the tricks I learned on how to make this thing work for me. This was not exactly like mine, the one that I had, but it's really hard to find a medical stomach tube somewhere in the country for me to use as a prop, I guess. Anyway, so what is a stomach tube? What's a PEG tube? A PEG tube is a type of feeding tube that's used when you can't swallow. Like for me, it was with throat cancer, and the treatments and stuff made it impossible for me to swallow any kind of liquid, certainly any kind of food. And so the only way for me to actually get any nutrients, any nutrition, any hydration into my body was through the tube. So that's what that's for. And there's two types. One is the, you have an NG tube, which goes through the nose, through the back of the esophagus, down to the stomach, and feeds that way. I don't know a lot about that. I didn't even know that existed until after I'd had my treatment. I'm not real sure I would have gone for that one, but I don't know. Evidently, that's a thing. I went with I had the PEG tube put in. That was kind of the only option I was given, and which results in the gastroenterologist. Yeah, that's the doctor. So the gastroenterologist comes in, cuts a small incision, and through your mouth, down the esophagus, there's a camera, checks everything, makes sure you don't have any ulcers, anything like that, runs the tube in using a small wire, feeds it in through the hole, attaches whatever. Like with me, there was another, like this grommet here, there's another grommet like that on the base end that kept it inside the stomach, so it'd be like that, right? So once the tube is in the stomach, then you use gauze tape it to the hole. It's got a hole in your stomach now, and you now have this hose going through your stomach. How do we use it now? Well, let's talk about it. Okay. Let's get ready to use the PEG tube. So the first thing we have to have is some water. A bottle of clean, fresh water is perfect for doing what we're gonna do. Whatever mix you're using, it can be a powder mix like this, such as Pediasure. You can see that right there. It's one of the things that was recommended by the nutritionist. Another thing that was recommended by the nutritionist was something called Glucerna in the can like that. That's a liquid premix. Used both actually, just mainly because I was bored of using the same thing over and over and over again. Next thing you want to do is have a couple of mixing cups. Big one and a little one. Your syringe, which is how you get your food into the tube. Okay, so got all my stuff together now. Let's get going. All right, so the first thing I want to do is I'm going to take a little bit of water and pour it into the tube. Pour it into a measuring cup, about a half cup of water in there, right? Now I'm going to take the stomach tube. I'm using this as a drain, actually, because it's not going into my stomach, so it's no real need in trying to make that mess happen. So first thing I would do is I would make sure that the clamp here, right here is closed, and that it's closed inside and it is clamped, keeping liquid from coming in and out. Anytime you use this, you want to make sure that clamp is closed right there. That keeps things from going in and also keeps stomach contents from coming back out. Especially when you lay down, sit back, something like that, stomach contents do kind of flow back and forth. All right, so we've got that floating in. We've got that in there. Next thing we'll do is make sure I've got my top open. And you'll notice on the PEG tube, you have a feed port and a cleaning port. All right, so two different ports. Use the feed port. That's a little bit bigger, and it's easier to get this inside. Get your it's easier to get your syringe inside. All right. So first thing we do is take a little bit of water, pull it up inside there. Insert your tube, like insert the syringe into the feeding tube, like so. Open the clamp like that, and then slowly. You're not trying to win a race here. Slowly. Slide it back so you can see it a little bit better. Cleanse your tube. Once push the fluids, any other stuff that happens to be in there, push it out. Right. All right. So we've got that done. Now, once we've done that, make sure you have clamped it again. Remove your syringe, and let's do it again one more time. We're going to pull it through. Good, fully. Now, just doing a couple of things here. You're cleaning out the tube, and you're also adding a little bit. You're also getting a little bit more water into your system, liquid into your system. All right, hydration's kind of key on this stuff. So we open up our clamp again at the bottom, and again. Slowly let the water drain out. Push it out just very gently. I'm barely pushing with my finger here. And push it out of your system, all the way through the tube, all right? So it also is helping keep any blockages in at the end of the tube that you can't see from staying in there and interfering with you getting your food in, all right? Now, we'll remove the tube again. Or I'm sorry, we're going to remove the syringe. We set the syringe down. We're going to use our can of Glucerna here. Give it a good shake. And we'll pour the Glucerna into my measuring cup. Again, about a half, just a little over half a cup of Glucerna. All right, see that? I don't know if you can't see how much that is, but it's about a little over a half a cup. I think it comes out to 150 milliliters, okay? So, set that down to the side, set the can off to the side. Now, one of the things I did, and this is a trick I learned, was to add water to your pre-mixed food drink, basically. It doesn't affect the taste because you can't taste anything. But what it did is it helped things go down a little smoother in the system, helped things go through your peg tube a little easier. So I would add just a little bit of water in there, making it almost a full cup, which is about 250 milliliters, okay? Now, one thing I would do is then take... One thing you can do is take the plunger out of your syringe, insert the syringe back into the feed port. This is key. Make sure you get this thing in there tight, because this will swell over time, get stretched out, and there's nothing worse than pouring whatever you're drinking in through this tube and having it pop loose and it going all over the place because you can't stop it. It just flows right out. And you've got Glucerna all over the table, all over the couch, all over your clothes, all over the counter. And it's aggravating, makes you pretty angry. All right. So now I would take this. I would then pour this inside like so, carefully, 60 milliliters. All right, that's a full syringe, right? You agree with me? Full syringe. All right, then slowly open your valve and let this stuff start flowing out. You don't have to open it up all the way, and you don't have to leave it. It doesn't matter how fast you do it. Your stomach's empty, just pour it through, right? I would always then pinch this shut. Because again, inevitably, if you're moving around, the syringe will come off of this. And if there's nothing in it, there's nothing to fall out, right? Now, the next thing I would do, and this was just for me, Nobody ever told me this. This is all stuff I learned. Take some water, pour it through. 60 at a time, because that way you're not too full. You're not filling up the syringe so much. Drain out the water. Let it clean out your tube, clean all the food particles out, all the goo and gunk and everything else. Because every time you move from down here, the stomach, the contents of your stomach will come back up into the tube every time you move if you haven't pinched it off good. Take that out. Close it. Your feed tube's now complete and you've finished feeding yourself. Okay, that's it. Basically how you use a feeding tube, the PEG tube. One thing I wanted to share with you that I picked up was this thing. It's called a feeding tube pouch. And I'm wearing this over my shirt. Usually it'd be under my shirt. This tube would be inside here like this. Where this is connected to my stomach. This would be connected to my stomach. This disc would be next to my stomach. I'm going to pull that through just a little bit so it's a little more comfortable for right now. And the tube would come through just as you see it like this. Now, prior to this, before I got this thing, I was having to try to tape the tube to my chest, to my stomach, somewhere out of the way, right? And it just kept getting in the way. You can see how the tube would flip up and it didn't look right. So I looked on the internet, Amazon and a couple other places, maybe your medical supply store will have what's called a stomach tube kit, abdominal tube kit, something like that. You can even take a still of this, take it and show it to them. So then what I would do is after I finished or whatever I was doing, take it, close it, like this, neat, out of the way, nice and clean, and certainly with the elastic, a lot more comfortable than taping it to your stomach, because tape's just a pain in the neck, everybody knows that. One thing I did to it is I did a little modification, is I cut this square out right here, because again, since this is hooked to my stomach like that, this would feed, because of the gap in it, I could feed this through there a lot easier than I could with it was just the little strip that was cut, or the little line that was cut in there, basically. But yeah, I thought this was one of the cooler things I discovered. My gastro guy was, my gastroenterologist, Dr. Hassan, was amazed by it. I gave him a couple of spare ones I had. I ended up with three of these things that I use regularly. Wash it. I always have one washing, drying, and wearing one. Wear it for a couple days or so. You can get in the shower with it. It doesn't really matter to swap it out for the next one, right? Not a big deal. Definitely one of the smarter things I found, one of the coolest things out there for what we have to go through. We already got enough problems. We don't need any more. So that's it. Those are my tips and tricks for using the stomach tube.